"Move or starve." Those were the words one Oklahoma migrant chose to describe his options. Between 1935 and 1940, over 300,000 Oklahomans, a third of our population at that time, moved out of state in search of work. Those who left faced the hardships of the Great Depression, and those who stayed choked on clouds of dust. It's an often told tale here in Oklahoma, yet the real story is one that goes well beyond bad weather and hard times and speaks to lessons we can still learn from today. As the first tanks rolled through Europe during the First World War, America's farmers were plowing the plains. Demand for U.S. wheat had never been higher. When America entered the conflict, Washington urged farmers to produce even more with the slogan, "Food will win the war."
Then we reaped the golden harvest. Then we really plowed the plains.
Prices more than doubled, and farmers flocked to fields hoping to cash in. But the demand was a bubble that would burst. After the war, prices plunged, and farmers armed with tractors responded to falling prices by planting more, hoping increased volume could offset decreasing prices.
We had the manpower. We invented new machinery. The world was our market.
Over 5 million new acres were planted in the 1920s by farmers hoping to survive the downturn. But it wasn't to be. When the stock market crashed in 1929, America's heartland was already in trouble. A drought was just beginning. Banks began to close, and equipment lay idle in the field. And then the winds began to blow.
A country without rivers, without streams, with little rain.
Left little cover for tilled ground, and dust storms began to blow. By the end of 1931, a survey showed of the 16 million acres of land cultivated in Oklahoma, 13 million was severely eroded, and our state was to face a test like no other.